that we're doing the braised spare ribs with Japanese squash. So this spare ribs has been marinated. You can look for my YouTube video under marinated ground pork and spare ribs Japanese squash. The ingredient is shallot, star anise, about few, and piece of ginger. And this is the green onion for garnish at the end of the process. First, we got to do some by putting some cornstarch on them. For this amount, it's around 2 teaspoons. And in the meantime, I'm going to work on this Japanese starch. So don't cut it too small. If it is too small, after cooking, they all easily dissolve. This process is just to brown it up, but not to, you don't have to cook it throughout. Okay, this is the first step. So this is about a pound and a half. The amount of the spirit is a pound and a half. Oil is ginger and shallot. Not too high, hot. Some cooking wine for this one. We put some soy sauce. 2 teaspoons. For this amount, we'll put a 3/4 cup. 1 tablespoon of oyster sauce. So let it hot boiling for 3 minutes.This moment, try to make the squash, the pumpkin, the whole bath with the soup, the juice. We don't cook the squash all the way through, and the squash will be too mushy and disappear. Now we have to put some rock sugar into it. 10 grams, only 10 grams. So take out the squash.Squash is easily cooked, so you don't put them cooking through all the way. So by the time we near the end of this, then throw the squash back into it and thicken up the sauce. The squash I take out is nearly done. And this squash I put into the clay pot if you ever have. And I pour everything all over it. And cook it together with the clay pot.Spice like the star anise. And green onion we have cut it up and put on top.Stir it up a little bit. And bring it up to boil. Onion on top. it. And we're done. And then, oh, we add intro. All on top. And make it shiny. And we have a very nice dish of clay pot. Braised spareribs with Japanese squash.